Now we will learn about sources of modern Indian history. In classes 6 and 7, we have already read about the significance of various sources which we use to understand the events and the changes during the ancient and medieval period. Similarly, there are a number of sources which we use to understand the modern period of Indian history. Some of these are described below. So in order to the information which we have got from our past, there should be some evidence, some records, some statues, some monuments, some films through which we come to know what were the different types of activities which had taken place in our past. So let us find out one by one regarding the sources of modern Indian history. So the first is administrative records. Administrative records such as government orders and officials' correspondings are significant sources of historical information. So what do you mean by administrative records? They are the records which are official documents and government order. So they are known as administrative records. British officials believe that every official's proceeding should be properly recorded to enable clarity and also be available for future reference in case of disputes. So the British officials believed that there should be a proper document system, proper record of everything, so that it will be easy to use that record for further reference. The British also felt it necessary to preserve this record, which required separate rooms. So in order to record or in order to prevent this record, they had even made separate rooms so that they can keep all the documents, all the information in a room and keep it safe. Thus, each and every office, right from top down to the village, had special rooms. All branches of administration started the practice of communicating with each other in the form of letters, notings, reports, memos, etc. All these are preserved till this day in the archives. So all this information were kept in a room so that we can use in future for reference purpose, and also we can come to know what were the different types of activities which had taken place in our past. Second is books. The printing press was invented in the 15th century by a German named Johannes Gutenberg. So who had invented the printing press? He was the Johannes Gutenberg. Subsequently, the print technology underwent many changes. With the arrival of British, there was a huge growth in the production of books, magazine, newspaper and journal. So when the British had arrived in our India, there was a improvement or growth of the books, magazine, newspaper and journals in our country. Books that contain a collection of speeches like those delivered by Nehru or the 100 volumes of Gandhiji collected works are still extremely important, as they place the events in correct perspective. So with the help of these books, just like the speech delivered by the Nehru and the books or the works which were done by the Gandhiji, it is still kept or it is still preserved, so that until now we use it for reference purpose. Similarly, Dadabhai Naroji's poverty and un-British rule in India attacked the British government's economic policy and is an important source of for the economic history of this period. So one of the famous book known as Poverty and Un-British Rule in India, and it was written by whom? Dadabhai Naroji. And in this book, he had openly criticized about the British government and what are the different types of evil practices which were done by the British. So this is one of the most important source of economic history during those period. Premchand wrote about the peasant and the downtrodden. The play Neel Darpan by Dinabandhu Mitra also highlighted the exploitation of workers at indigo planters. So there are many details who had played an important role, and they are mentioned in this paragraph. That is, the first one is Nehru, next is Gandhiji, next is Dadabhai Naroji, the next is Premchand, and the other one is Dinabandhu Mitra. Autobiography and biographies of prominent personalities such as Mahatma Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru are extremely important as a source of historical information for this period. So the autobiographies and biographies of Mahatma Gandhi and Jawaharlal Nehru played an important role, so that we have come to know the different types of activities and different types of information which they had done, and what were the different contributions which they had done, so that we can get independence from the British rule. Books proved very helpful as they highlighted the exploitation of Indians by the British, whereas government records tell us only what the British government official thought or what they were interested in. So the books provide us different types of helpful information through which we can come to know that how British exploited us, and with the help of government records it tell us what are the different types of rules and regulations which were done by the British and what they wish to preserve for prosperity. These books help in the spread of nationalist spirit among the masses. So with the help of these books also, the you can say the different types of leaders were able to convey or spread their messages through this book, and so that they can join us in a movement against the British rule. Next is newspaper, magazine, letters and pamphlet. A large number of newspaper, magazines and pamphlet were printed throughout the India in different languages. So different types of newspaper, magazines and pamphlets were printed throughout India and in the different languages, that means the native languages, for example Sanskrit, Urdu, Hindi, Marathi and so on. Some of these are still in publication with a record of their old edition symmetrically kept in their library. So even these newspapers, pamphlets and newspapers are kept in the different types of libraries and in the museum for so that we can come to know how the newspapers and magazines and pamphlets were being published during those time. Bal Gangadhar Tilak's Kesari in Marathi is one of the most notable examples. So example is Bal Gangadhar Tilak's Kesari, and it was written in Marathi language. Reading these papers recreate before us an atmosphere which prevailed 100 years ago or so. While reading these papers, we can recreate the scene which had already taken place in our past. Letters are especially important as they help us understand the prevailing situation from a personal point of view. So with the help of letters, we can come to know the different types of information, how a person used to write and how they used to deal with the situation, or how they used to transfer or spread the information to the local masses. Next is photographs, paintings and statues. Photography was a new art medium and extremely valuable as it captured historical moments for prosperity and facilitate an almost perfect historical representation. So with the help of photography, it was an art medium and it was very valuable. Why? Because they were being captured, and till now we have got different types of pictures which had taken place, or different types of buildings which were there during the British rule with the help of this photography. Various statues and rare paintings are not only important as works of art, but they also tell us something about the physical features and achievements of the national leaders and great historical personalities. So with the help of different types of statues and paintings, we come to know different types of important works which they had done during those period, and it also tells different types of physical features and different achievements which the different national leaders had done during those period. Next is film. Documentary as well as feature films also help in the study of this period. So with the help of documentary or the different types of films, we come to know how these activities took place. The impression left after watching such films is of more permanent nature as we see events with our own eyes. So when we see these documentary or different types of films which had taken place during those time, we can get the feeling how that particular event had taken place when we see with our own eyes. Sir Richard Attenborough's film Gandhi includes as an actual news reel of Gandhiji visit to Manchester. So a book, you can say a movie known as Gandhi, it was done by Richard Attenborough. He had tried to recreate the situation where he had visit to Manchester. Another film, Achyut Kanya, the love story of an untouchable girl and a Brahmin boy, was a commercial success. So there is one more example known as Achyut Kanya, and it was a story between a untouchable girl, that means the lower section of the society, and a Brahmin boy. So it was very famous during those time. Many such films are stored with the film division. So even at present, there are many of the films which are stored by the
you can say film division, and they kept try to recreate those situation in the upcoming movies. So here are the in a table which is in page number 133. These are the some newspaper, magazine and periodicals, and what was the name of that newspaper, who was the founder or the editor, and in which language they were published, and in which year they were launched. So it is very important. Next is monuments. A number of famous monuments and buildings belonging to this period can be seen throughout the length and breadth of the country. Most of these have many stories, episodes linked with them. Some of these are the India Gate, Parliament House, Rashtrapati Bhavan and Birla House, where Gandhiji assassinated. So there are other monuments which help us to know how these how our India's or you can say how different types of monuments were made during the British rule. The examples are India Gate, Parliament House, Rashtrapati Bhavan and Birla House, where Gandhiji was assassinated, that means where he was buried. All these buildings tell us much about our near past, the different aspect of the architecture of India of that time. So with the help of these monuments, we come to know how different types of monuments were erected during those period, what were the materials which were used, what were the different types of style they used in order to make the monuments. So here is a picture of Parliament House and the India Gate in Delhi, stand out as two of the finest example of Cornwallian architecture. So they are made by British rule. Last topic of the chapter is surveys and mapping. The British believed that a country had to be properly known before it could be effectively administered. So the British believed that in order to run the country in a better way, they have to make different types of rules and regulation, and they have to make their administration more strong. So they started by conducting survey and mapping. So in order to make the administration to run in a better way, they started doing survey, that means collecting information and going to the different types of areas and look how the situation are. So they started doing surveys and mapping. The survey of India was set up in Dehradun, which made detailed map of towns, village, mountains and coast. So the survey of India was made in Dehradun by the British colonial, and their main agenda was to make detailed map of towns, village, mountains and coast. The first survey general of Bengal was appointed in 1767 and the first surveyor general of India in 1815. George Everest became the survey general in 1830. So this is very important, remember it. In 1849, the height of Mount Everest was calculated and it was named after him for his exemplary contribution. So the name of the Mount Everest was named on the honor of George Everest, because he was the first person who had gave contribution, and he was the first person who had measured the height of the Everest. So that's why at present Mount Everest is known as Mount Everest, because in order to honor the George Everest. The map of the Hyderabad region made by Dr. H.W. Wavesay in 1829 was the first proper geographical map made in India. So which place was the first place where geographical map of India was made? It was the Hyderabad, and it was done by whom? Dr. H.W. Wavesay in 1821. It is very important. Maps of towns, cities, villages and roads etc. were made. So different types of maps were made which differentiate differentiate how the cities were, how the villages were, roads and towns were. These maps help us today to know about the kind of rural and urban pattern of settlement. So with the help of these maps, we come to know how the cities were divided during the British period, how there was a difference between urban, that is town, and the rural, that means village pattern system, how the houses were made, how the whole cities were divided. So everything we can get the information with the help of map. In villages, revenue surveys were conducted. So in the villages, revenue surveys, that means how for example in a family, how many members are there who earn and what amount of money they earn each month. From the end of the 19th century, census operations were held every 10 years to prepare detailed records of the number of people in India. So after the, or you can say by the end of 19th century, the census were held. That means collecting information about the whole country, and it was done in between 10 years of duration. For example, if census had taken place at present, for example, if census had taken place in this year, that means at present year, that is 2021, then the next census will take place in 2031. So every 10 years the census were held by the British rule, and by this we end the chapter.